Hello my Einsteinians friends, my name is Farid Albert Leon, and I am very happy to tell you a little about my most precious hobby, science. I will now talk to you about the year 1905, a wonderful year for science, Einstein, among the five scientific articles that he published that advanced the world, strongly attracts my attention. Does the inertia of a body depend on its energy? Next, we are going to study part 3 of step by step the meaning of the key terms of the equations that Einstein proposed in this wonderful year, writing about E equals mass times the speed of light squared. Today we show part 3, step by step explanation of Einstein's 1905 article. Role of kinetic energy and application of the Taylor series. From the equations of the energy balance in reference to the law of conservation of energy, which we saw at the end of part 2 of this series of videos, which we will call expression 1. By subtraction of the two states in relative motion, we obtain the expression 2. In the analysis of this last equation, we can see that the energy differences of the form, H minus E, that appear in this expression have simple physical meanings. The energies H and E are values of the energy of the same body referred to two coordinate systems that move relative to each other, the body being at rest in one of the two systems, system at rest. Therefore, it is clear that the difference, H minus E, can be different from the kinetic energy K of the body, with respect to the other system in relative motion, system in motion, only by an additive constant C, which depends on the choice of the arbitrary additive constant of the energies H and E. Please see expression 3. So we have to ask, how is the kinetic energy K of the body involved with respect to the two coordinate systems? So we can place the expression 3 of the image shown, since constant additive C does not change during the emission of light. Then we will get expression 4 from the image. The kinetic energy of the body with respect to the reference system at rest decreases as a result of the emission of light, and the decreased amount is independent of the properties of the body. In addition, the kinetic energy difference, K0 minus K1, like the kinetic energy of the electron, depends on the velocity. Indeed, from expression 3, it can be deduced that the decrease in the kinetic energy of the body with respect to the system at rest is equal to expression 4. This shows that the emission of light has an effect on the kinetic energy of the body, and that this decrease is independent of the properties of the body. In addition, the amount of decrease in kinetic energy depends on the speed of the body. Simplifying expression 4, we can turn it into expression 5. What does this transformative step that Einstein makes? Where does it come from? In this step, Einstein is making an approximation in which he despises third order and higher magnitudes, see explanation below. This means that it is considering only the magnitudes of greater weight and discarding the negligible magnitudes. The simplification resulting from this approximation is that the difference of kinetic energy, K0 minus K1, can be approximated to expression 5. This approximation is based on the hypothesis that the relative velocity of the two reference frames, velocity of body is very very small compared to the speed of light, meaning that the ratio of body velocity to the speed of light of order n is a very small magnitude, for orders greater than 2. The mathematical justification behind this approach can be found in Taylor series theory, explained later. Reiterating the analysis of expression 4, what does it mean physically? This equation expresses the decrease in the kinetic energy of the body with respect to the system, at rest, after the emission of the light ray. The decrease in kinetic energy is obtained by subtracting the kinetic energy before emission, K0, and after emission, K1. The amount of decrease is given by the product of the energy of the emitted light, L, and a function that depends on the speed of the body with respect to light and the direction in which the light is emitted. So is it also true that the decrease in the kinetic energy of the body would be equivalent to expression 5? Yes, this is a correct way to express the decrease in the kinetic energy of the body after the emission of light, where m is the mass of the body and v is its velocity before the emission of light. Expected explanation, what happens if Taylor series are applied to the right side of expression 4, decrease in kinetic energy between the two systems? Yes, we can apply Taylor series to expand the function in expression 4. The Taylor series is a mathematical representation that allows approximating a function to an infinite sum of terms, where each term is a power of the variable on which it is expanding, multiplied by a coefficient that depends on the values of the function and its derivatives at a given point, which will allow to calculate the value of the kinetic energy function with a desired accuracy, depending on the number of terms that are included in the sum. However, this expansion will only be valid within an interval in which the function is sufficiently smooth, and where the velocity v is much less than the speed of light. What would be the exact first terms of that Taylor series expansion? This expansion can be used to obtain appropriate approximations for certain values of velocity. However, it is important to note that the accuracy of this expansion depends on the term, speed of the body over the speed of light, raised to the power n, and that the expansion is only valid for values of the relative velocity of the bodies that are much less than the speed of light. Next, we mathematically and physically support the application of the terms of the Taylor expansion to expression 4, to make Einstein's equation viable in the field of relativity. A table was made where the impact of Taylor's terms on the physical phenomenon of bodies or masses, or electromagnetic energies that move in relation to a reference system at rest is measured, obtaining a map of applicability of the approximation. In this map, all terms of order greater than 2 are eliminated, and the areas where the approximation makes sense are highlighted in green. It would take the body in motion relative to the system at rest to travel at more than 5% of the speed of light for it to begin to mean 0.12% the fourth order term of the Taylor series, which is equivalent to more than 43 million kilometers per hour. Very soon, we will continue with part 4 of this Einstein writing. Final step, how did Einstein arrive at the compact equation, E is equal to mass multiplied by speed of light squared? Final step, how did Einstein arrive at the compact equation, E equals mass times the speed of light squared? We will see the conclusion very soon. Bye, my dear friends.